Hello students, how are you? I hope you all are fit and fine. So dear students, as you all are aware that in my last video dated 21st August 2021, I finished the explanation of chapter 7, the Ebonds, Trace and O Level. And after we have finished that lesson, we have finished our syllabus. So from today we are going to start the revision of term 1. Okay, so we will focus on MCQs, and we will once again discuss the summary of all the lessons which are going to come in first lesson, in first term. Okay, then we will practice MCQs. After I'll summarize the lesson, then we will practice MCQs. As in term 1, you all are aware that only MCQs will be there. Okay, so let's begin. Lesson 1, the last lesson, written by Alphonse Daudet. About the author, Alphonse Daudet, who lived between 1840 to 1897. He was a French novelist and short story writer. The last lesson is set in the days of the Franco-Prussian War, which took place in 1870 to 1871, in which France was defeated by Prussia, led by Bismarck. Prussia then consisted of what now are the nations of Germany, Poland and parts of Austria. In this story, the French districts of Alsace and Lorraine have passed into Prussian hands. Now let us read the story to find out what effect this had on life at schools in Alsace and Lorraine. So before moving ahead, already during explanation I have made you write. So just if you did not write during the explanation, you can write them right now. In a great dread of, the phrase "in great dread of" means in immense fear or anxiety. In great dread of means in immense fear or anxiety. Next word is, next phrase is in unison. In unison means in agreement or harmony. Next phrase is counted on, which means relief, which means relied on or was sure of. Next phrase is the great bustle, that means a lot of activity. Next phrase is thumbed at the edges, which means folded at the corners. Reproach ourselves, this is the next phrase, which means criticize or blame ourselves. Okay, already I have made you write during my explanation, so those who have missed, they can write it down right now. So as already line by line explanation of the lesson has been done, so you all are aware of what this lesson is about. So let us go through the theme first. So as we all know, the pain that is inflicted on the people of a territory by its conquerors by taking away their right of studying or speaking in their own language. This lesson depicts the importance of one's language in his/her existence. It also brings out linguistic chauvinism. Now, sub-theme of the lesson, students and teachers' attitude to teaching and learning and the habit of postponing learning. So this is the sub theme of this lesson. Now what values we can get from this lesson? So we don't value something when we have it, but repent when we lose it. Today's youth is involved in violence, bad politics, inter and intra group conflicts. Peace and tranquility have been lost somewhere. They do not have respect for the nation and our mother tongue at all. Patriotism is a noble sentiment based on devotion and unconditional love of people for their country. We have secured freedom but not utilized freedom in its true perspective. The need of the hour is the revival of patriotic spirit among the youth. Now let us go through a short summary of the lesson. France was defeated by Prussia in the Franco-Prussian War in 1870 to 1871. Orders from Berlin came to teach only German in the schools of Alsace and Lorraine. It suddenly awakened the spirit of patriotism and a love for their language in every heart. An atmosphere of regret and deep loss hung in the class. Usually, when school began, there was a great bustle which could be heard out in the street, the opening and closing of desks, lessons repeated loudly, and the teacher's great ruler rapping on the table. But now there was unusual calm. The whole school seemed so strange and so lame. The only sound that could be heard was the scratching of the pens on paper. Even the writing and history lessons were noiseless. M. Hemmel had never explained everything with so much patience. All were sitting with seriousness, keen to grasp everything. The most surprising thing was that the back benches, they were always vacant. Now they were occupied by the village elders, old Hauser and his three-cornered hat, the former postmaster, the former mayor, and several others. It was because they felt regret and they had not gone to school, as they had not gone to school more. Secondly, it was their way of thanking M. Hemmel for his 40 years of faithful service and of showing respect for the country that was theirs no more. M. Hemmel said, "My children, this is your last French lesson. The order has come from Berlin to teach only German in the schools of Alsace and Lorraine." These words were the thunderclap to France. France now understood what they had put up on the bulletin board at the town hall. France felt regret for not learning his lessons, for seeking birds' eggs or going sliding on the sash. He felt that he would miss his school. He developed liking for history and grammar. For him, M. Hemmel became a good teacher from a boring one. He was genuinely upset that Amhemel would leave the country next day. This is the short summary. Now let us go through extra shots, some additional points which we must keep remember. So as we have read in the lesson, we all are aware, Franz started for school very late that morning. He was in great dread of scolding because Amhemel had said that he would question them on participles, and he did not know the first word about them. Franz thought of running away and spending the day out of doors, and was so warm, so bright, as it was so warm, so bright. The birds were chirping at the edge of the woods. In the open field, the Prussian soldiers were drilling. It was all much more tempting than the rules of participles. But Franz had the strength to resist the temptation and hurried off to school. When Franz passed the town hall, there was a crowd in front of the bulletin board. For the last 2 years, all bad news had come from there only. The lost battles, the draft, the orders of commanding officers. Franz wondered what matter could be now. As Franz hurried off to school, the blacksmith watcher, who was reading the bulletin, called after him, "Don't go so fast, Bub. You'll get to your school in plenty of time." Franz thought he was making fun of him. When Franz reached the school, he saw his classmates already in their places, and Amhemel walking up and down with the terrible iron ruler under his arm. So Franz was blushed and frightened, as he was very late and did not learn the rule of participles. Amhemel had put on his beautiful green coat, his frilled shirt, and the little black silk cap, all embroidered. He never wore such clothes except on inspection and prize days. It was in honor of the last lesson that he had put on his fine Sunday clothes. After the writing and history lessons, the babies chanted their ba, be, bi, bo, bu. The old Hauser, who had put on his spectacles and holding his primer in both hands, was trying to spell the letters. He was crying. His voice trembled with emotion. It was so funny to hear him that all wanted to laugh and cry. Amhemel blamed the parents as they were not anxious enough about the children's lessons. They preferred to put them work on the farm and at the mills, so as to have a little more money. Amhemel blamed himself also. He often sent the children to water his flowers instead of learning their lessons. And when he wanted to go fishing, he just gave them a holiday. So it's all about the lesson. Once again, we have gone through the summary. Now, dear students, let us practice MCQs. Okay? So first I'll make you write down, then we will discuss the answer. Okay? So everyone get ready with your paper and pen. And read the extract from this paragraph. Read the extract from your book. I'm reading out the paragraph. When I passed the town hall, there was a crowd in front of the bulletin board. For the last 2 years, all our bad news had come from there. The lost battles, the draft, the orders of the commanding officer. And I thought to myself, without stopping, what can be the matter now? Then, as I hurried by as fast as I could go, the blacksmith watcher who was there with his apprentice reading the bulletin called after me. Don't go so fast, Bob. You'll get to your school in plenty of time. So please read this extract and answer to this question. Question number one. Who was called Bob? Who was called Bob? Options are A. M. Hamel, B. Watcher, C. Franch, and D. Oldhauser. Now, question number two. What did the narrator think? What did the narrator think when the blacksmith called after him? When the blacksmith called after him. So, when the blacksmith called after him and said, so this line I'm just reading out, don't go so fast, Bob. You will get to your school in plenty of time. Okay? So I hope you have written this question. Let me write down the options. Option A, the school was closed today. The school was closed today. Option B, keep writing. Option B, it was the last lesson today. It was the last lesson. Let me repeat, then write down all the options so that you can see it clearly. Yes, option A, this is the school was closed today. The school was closed today. Option B, it was the last lesson today. It was the last lesson today. It was the last lesson today. And next, he was making fun of him. was making fun of him. He was making fun of him. And next D, none of these. None of these. Next is none of these. Okay. So please write down and choose the correct option. As these two questions are very easy, which we have just written, and hoping that you have chosen your answers. Okay. So after we have finished completely, we will discuss the answers. Okay. So keep completing, keep writing the answers. Keep writing the answers. Okay. Now I'm going to rub it. I'm going to write down the next question. Just wait a minute. All questions and their answers must be written in a fair mode. It is compulsory. Okay. So practice well so that you can write your examination, so that you can attend the questions to your examination properly. As in MCQs, it will be very difficult if you are not in practice. Okay. Now, question third. Question number third. Identify the tone in which the speaker said the words. Identify the tone in which the speaker said the words, in which the speaker said the words, don't go so fast, bub, you will get to your school in plenty of time. Identify the tone in which the speaker said the words, don't go so fast, bub, you will get your school in plenty of time. Okay, let me make you write down the options for this third question. Sarcastic, sarcastic. B, humorous. B, humorous. C, depressive. D, cheerful. And D, cheerful. D, cheerful. Okay, sarcastic, humorous, depressive, cheerful. Now question number 4, let me rub it and write down question number 4. Question number 4. What had been put up on the bulletin board? What had been put up on the bulletin board? Okay. What had been put up on the bulletin board? It is BIN, bulletin board. Option A, the news of the lost battles. The news of the lost battles. The news of the lost battles. B, the draft of the commanding officer. The draft of the commanding officer. The draft of the commanding officer. C, the order from Berlin to teach only German. C, the order, from Berlin, to teach only German. German in the schools of Elsis and Lauren. In the schools of Elsis and Lauren. In the schools of Elsis and Lauren. Okay, and option D, all of the above. Okay, what had been put up on the bulletin board? The news of the lost battles, the draft of the commanding officer, the order from Berlin to teach only German in the schools of Elsis and Lauren, and option D, all of the above. So we have written as of now 4 questions. Let us discuss answer to these questions. Then in my next video lessons, I'll discuss some more questions of such types. So who was Bob here? In this extract, when I passed the town hall, there was a crowd in front of the bulletin board for the last 2 years, the watcher said, don't go so fast, Bub, you will get to your school in plenty of time. And options were M. Hemel, Watcher, Franz, Oldhauser. So you all are aware that it was Franz. Okay. Second one, what did the narrator think when the blacksmith called after him and said, don't go so fast, Bob. You will get to your school in plenty of time. So you all must be knowing this answer. Yes, it is. Let us read the four options. The school was closed today. No. It was the last lesson today. No. He was making fun of him. Yes. As he was getting late, so that is why he was making. Don't go so fast, Bob. You will this is B option is correct. It was the last lesson today. Okay, so identify the tone in which the speaker said the words. Don't go so fast, Bob. You will get to your school in plenty of time. It is sarcastic, humorous, depressive, or cheerful. Yes, it was a sarcastic comment. Now, extremely sorry, beta. Depressive is most suitable answer here because he was also sad, na? So that is why depressive is the most suitable answer. So what had been put up on the bulletin board? The news of the lost battles, the draft of the commanding officer, the order from Berlin to teach only German in the schools of. So we all are aware that the last one is correct. All of these. So it's all about this video lesson. In the next video lesson, we will be discussing some more MCQs. Thank you for watching. See you tomorrow.